you have, man, when it comes to Indy cars, you have something here that may be considered by people that follow the Indianapolis 500 as the car, perhaps. Tell us about this.
This is one of the most famous race cars in the world, and it's the winner of the 1959 Indianapolis 500, driven by Roger Ward, and the car was built by A.J. Watson. It's 400 horsepower, it's a 4.2-liter engine, and it started third in the Indianapolis 500, and he ended up winning.
Mm-hmm. That's an Offenhauser in this, right?
Yes, it's top speed is 180 miles an hour. And they actually outlawed this vehicle a few years later because the front end with the engine pushed right back onto the driver and was very dangerous.
Right. When you think of current safety standards and you look at this thing is, it's pretty, but it's crude. It's really crude.
These actually just had a lap belt on them. It just... You know, drivers were getting thrown out of the car, so yeah, absolutely.
And I've seen footage of with these so exposed where they come up on another car and the two tires meet and you got a big problem.
In that race, in the Indianapolis 500 in 1959, actually one of the cars did flip over in that race, So it's kind of scary.
And speaking of that, this has a little bit of a dark past to it. Tell us about that.
Yeah, after the 59 Indianapolis 500, this car was test driven for Russo by Tony Bettenhausen, and he actually died testing this vehicle, and a few years later was completely restored by A.J. Watson, who originally built the car.
So you're kind of covering the biggest way you could lose in an Indy car was not surviving, and the biggest way, of course, you could win was to actually win the race with this. This is amazing. What's the reaction of people? Does everybody know what this, I mean, just to see Roger Ward written on the side says this is really important, but does it click with people? Do they realize what a significant piece of automotive history is here?
It's funny, there's three different types of people walk in. There's people that have no idea about this car, and it's just a neat little vehicle. And then there's people that know the name Roger Ward, but then there's a few people that come in and they see this car, and they just cannot believe that this car is right here in Colorado at our facility right in front of their eyes.